Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. Let's talk about Microsoft Teams and the ability of having a team for the purpose of only information sharing. You don't want to have conversations with people. You just want to share some files possibly and some other information. So how do we control it so that people in our team do not add to the post area? That's what I'm going to show you in this video today. We're going to do a demonstration with my information team that I have a sample of, and you're going to see how that's all possible. Let's get to it so you understand this. So first off, whenever you have a team, so my team example here is information is the team. I have a general channel. So if I click on that, you'll see there's some posts in here of some activity that's been happening. I have a channel on information for the training of SharePoint. No posts happening here yet. And then I have some information regarding training for Teams. And there's a little bit of post going on here. As you see, it's all added by myself. Nobody else has been interacting with this. But let's say that the reason we want to have this team is because we purely want to be able to share information with everybody in this team so they have the information they need, so they can read it, they can access it, but they don't need to make any extra posts or conversations around it. So if that's your intention for a particular team, I'm going to show you how to turn the post feature off so that nobody is adding posts in here, so that you don't have to monitor it. Let's put it that way. Okay, so this is completely optional, and this is not the default. Normally every team, it's expected that you want to have conversations with other people. So this is a very different example, and I'm giving you this example because actually a client of mine was working on this the other day, and we were just going about how do we create this read-only team with read-only channels. Okay, so let's go to it. So I'm going to go to the three dots on my team, and that gives me the menu, and I'm going to go to manage team. And I just want to show you first off that there are team members here. So I'm the owner of this team, and I have some members. So we have some other people as members and guests. Okay, so there are in fact other people that could post to this channel. So let's go to the channels themselves. And then we see general, the training for SharePoint channel, the training for Teams channel. So in the general channel, we're going to go to the three dots and we're going to manage that channel. And so we can see at the bottom here that right now anybody can post a message in this channel. We don't want that. So we're going to say only the owners can post messages. So the one we're choosing is we don't want anybody posting other than the owner. So the owners of that channel, that could be one owner or multiple owners, can add posts in, and the people that are a part of that channel can then read those posts. Okay, so that's the general channel. So now we're going to go back. So I'm just going to use my back button at the top here. And I want to go to my training for SharePoint. And let's go to the three dots beside that and manage the channel for that one. So here the menu is a bit different, right? So we don't see the same options as we did in the general channel. So this is because this is a channel we created. So any channels we create, these are the permissions that we're gonna see. And so what we have to keep in mind is at the very top, it talks about moderation. So moderation is where you're saying, or this is saying that the channel moderation is turned off. So in other words, no one is controlling who is talking or who is communicating in this channel. So there's no moderator. So we want to turn that from off to on and then see what our options are. So let's just do that. Turn that on. And now it says who are the moderators. So it makes sense that the team owners are the moderators. Your other choices would be the team members or the team guests. So team owners is kind of the most likely one. Okay. So the important thing to see right next is that who can start a new post? Only the moderators. So that's the team owner. So the three other people that are on my team cannot start a post. Do I want the members of my team to be able to reply to a message? So that's an option. So I can say, no, I don't need them to reply. Do I want them to pin a message to the top? So maybe there's some important messages and they don't want to lose track of them. Should I let them pin it somewhere in the message area? And only they would see their pins. That seems pretty easy to just allow that. And then these other two are kind of more automated messages that happen when you do something. So bots are other apps that you could have available within your team. So maybe you have a poly app that is keeping track of votes on something. Or you could have connectors as well. And so these are just automated messages that are updating the team of things that are happening. So you can choose whether that makes sense for you to continue to have, or should we turn it off? I think I'll turn those ones off. So really, if I post a message, that I'm going to say, I don't need anybody to reply. It's just because this is just for information only. So, but I may want people to decide which messages they pin so they can have some order to what they're looking at. So let's leave that on. Okay, so that is for the share training for SharePoint channel. Now we're going to, and we've done the general channel. So now we're going to go out of here. So hit the back button so it saves as we go here. And now we want to go to training for Teams and hit the manage channel there. And same menu as well. So I'm going to turn that on and then I can uncheck the same ones if I want to. Okay, so that's your options that you have here. If I now go back in, let's just go to general to start with. Nothing's really going to change. You're not going to notice any difference. The change is that no one can post, right, into these different channels that we change the options for. And so, by the way, I was using the three dots at the top to go to the team and kind of show you everything from there. If you go to a channel and hover on it, there are three dots there as well. And you can manage the channel from this direction as well. So you have a more than one way of doing this. Okay, so hopefully that helps you. That helps you see that there is some different flexibilities within Microsoft Teams. You could have a team that's just for the purpose of sharing information with a group of people. Nothing to be discussed, just purely information to be given. And this is how you can go about it. All right, so try that out. Thanks. Bye-bye.